Hello everyone, welcome back. In the previous video, we have discussed about what do you mean by an algorithm, as well as we have discussed about what are the important properties that an algorithm should have. Now in today's video, we are going to discuss about what do you mean by an efficiency of an algorithm, or let me call it as what do you mean by the complexity of an algorithm. Note that the complexity of any algorithm can be classified as the time complexity as well as the space complexity. So if you see here, I have clearly mentioned that the efficiency of the algorithm or the algorithm complexity are of two different types. The first one we call it as the space efficiency, or it is also called as the space complexity. And the second one, it is called as the time complexity or the time efficiency. Let me define the space complexity as: the space complexity can be defined as the amount of space required by an algorithm to solve a particular problem. Now coming to the time complexity, indicates how fast the algorithm or how fast the program runs. Or it can also be defined as how long a program takes to process a particular input to transform into an output. These are the two different attributes on which we find the time complexity of a particular algorithm. The space complexity of a particular algorithm can be expressed with an equation denoted as S of P, wherein S denotes the space and P denotes the problem. That is, the space complexity of a particular problem can be described as the summation of the space required to store. Maybe C denotes the constant part, or I can call it as a, this is a, the independent variables used in the algorithm or in the program, and S of P of instance denotes the variable part. Variable part which are dependent, or I can call C as the space required for the algorithm to execute, which is nothing but the space used to store the local variables, local or the input. Let me call S of P as an S of P is the variable part, wherein is the space used to store the temporary variables, or I can call it as the auxiliary variables. This is about the space complexity. Note that the space complexity is the amount of space required by an algorithm to solve a particular problem, wherein the space complexity can be expressed as S of P, wherein S denotes the space and P denotes the problem. That is, the space taken to execute, to solve a particular problem, is nothing but the space required to store the constant part, as well as the space required to store the variable part used in the algorithm. Let's consider two different examples to understand how to find the space complexity of an algorithm. Here, we'll assume that each variable used in the algorithm uses a constant space which is denoted with 1. That is, 1 is a constant space used to store a variable used in the algorithm to store a particular value. Now, coming to the first example. In the first example, I have taken a very small algorithm wherein the algorithm finds the summation of two numbers A and B. Now, in this particular case, as we denoted SP, S of P, which was the space complexity denoted with C plus SP of an instance, wherein C was an independent part or a constant part, and SP was the dependent part. Now, in this particular example, there are two variables A and B, and the only statement in the algorithm is return A plus B. So, A is a constant and B is also a constant. Therefore, in this, C is 1 plus 1, 1 to store the value of A and one more unit to store the value of B, which is 2, and SP, there are no dependent dependent part in the algorithm at all. So, its value is 0. So, therefore, the total space complexity of the algorithm to solve this particular problem is 2 plus 0, which is nothing but 2, which is a constant. which is a constant. Further, you will see, while discussing the asymptotic notation, we'll denote that constant with a value 1. I'll write it as order of 1. Please don't worry about what you mean by order of 1. Maybe in the next video, we'll see what exactly you mean by the asymptotic notation. So for this particular example, the space complexity of this algorithm is constant. Now coming to this second algorithm, the second algorithm finds the summation of all the elements stored in an array. Now in this algorithm, if you see, there is a variable by name sum, which is initialized to 0, and there is a for loop that has been executed from 0 to n minus 1, and each of the value of a that is stored in the location I, which ranges from 0 to n minus 1, is being summated to this variable sum. And finally, we are returning the value sum. In this case, let me write the formula as S of p is equal to c plus sp of instance. Okay. I repeat, c is this space taken to store all the constants used in the algorithm, and sp is the auxiliary part. Now in this case, c is sum. One is sum, and the second one is n. N denotes the number of n denotes the number of elements in the array. So c is equal to 1 to hold the value of sum, and one more constant space to hold the value of n. So it is 2. Now coming to sp of instance, that is the auxiliary part. Here the auxiliary part is the number of elements that we are going to store it in case of the array A. If the value of n is 10, then we are going to store 10 elements in the array A. Now in this case, so what we can do is, okay, I'll write it as 10 into n. 10 into n. So this is the auxiliary part. Now, therefore, the total space S of P is equal to 2 plus 10n. Assuming that there are n elements, there are 10 elements in the array. If there are 20 elements, then this auxiliary part will be 20n. Now, this is nothing but out of this 2 plus 10n, I will take the bigger one as 10n. Now, even this 10n, 10 is a constant. So, this is nothing but order of n. So this is the space complexity of the second algorithm. Coming to the time complexity part of an algorithm, as we have defined, the time complexity indicates how fast the algorithm runs. Generally, the time complexity depends on several things, and some of those are, first one is the system on which the algorithm is being executed. If I transform that particular algorithm into a piece of code, and if I want to execute that particular code, then it depends on what system I want to execute. If the system that I am using is a very old system, which is a 486 machine, then obviously the time taken to execute that particular code will be very high when compared to the latest machine, which might be a P7 machine. It also depends upon what type of programming language I am using to transform the algorithm into a particular code. As we know that if I execute a program on with the help of Python, then the Python programs are much faster when compared to the traditional C or C++ program. Similarly, the third thing might be the compiler that I am using to execute that particular program. Now, in case if I want to find the time complexity of an algorithm, and if I am using all these things to find the time taken to execute the algorithm, then obviously it varies from one system to another system. So, with these three things, I can't find the actual time complexity. Because it varies from one system to another system, or it varies from one programming language to another programming language. So whenever we find the time complexity of the algorithm, generally we don't go, generally we don't depend on these things. So to find the time complexity of an algorithm, we go by what is the basic operation of the algorithm. So note that in order to find the time complexity of an algorithm, we calculate how many times
the basic operation. Basic operation in the sense, say for example, in case of sorting, the basic operation would be comparison. In case of searching algorithm, the basic operation would be comparison statement. So, depending upon how many times this basic operation gets executed, we find the time complexity. How many times the basic operation gets executed. This can be denoted with the help of a statement, that is, the time complexity of a particular algorithm of input n is nothing but COP, where COP is nothing but the time taken to execute the basic operation once. So this is time taken for one execution or one instance of execution of the basic operation. Multiplied by C of n, where C of n is nothing but a function which expresses how many times the basic operation is being executed. So this is how we find the time complexity of any algorithm. Note that whenever we talk about the time complexity, it is not the amount of time taken by the algorithm for its execution on a system. Because as I clearly told that it varies from one system to another system. The time complexity of an algorithm can be calculated in a unique way with the help of how many times the basic operation gets executed. Note that the formula to be used is T of n is the time complexity. This is the time complexity. It is nothing but how many times, the number of times the basic operation gets executed. Coming to the definition of the basic operation. The basic operation is the most important operation of an algorithm. That is, it is the operation that contributes the most of the total running time. Now, depending upon how many times the basic operation gets executed for a particular input, the time complexity of an algorithm can be expressed as the best case, the worst case, and the average case. Now, what do you mean by best case? That means the best time complexity of an algorithm would be the minimum number of times the basic operation gets executed. For a particular input, if the basic operation gets executed minimum number of times, then it is expressed as the best case. What is the, just write, the best case is the minimum number of times the basic operation gets executed. For input n. Note that the best case, the worst case, and the average case depends upon what input that I am supplying to the algorithm. Say for example, if my objective is to search an element in a given array or in a given set of elements, I want to find my key element. And if the key element is present at the first position itself, and if I am using linear search, then the number of comparison that I am doing is 1. So, I'll say that in linear search, for a linear search algorithm, the minimum times that I do comparison is only 1 times. So, I say that the best case efficiency of linear search is order of 1. Now, in case of worst case, I can say the maximum number of times the basic operation gets executed for some input n. That is, for in case of linear search, when do I do maximum number of comparison? if I am trying to search an element which is there at the end of the array, or if the key that I am searching in the array, it is not there, then we do maximum number of comparison. That means I compare my key with all the elements in the array, then it denotes the worst case. So in case of worst case scenario, it depends upon what is the size of my array. So if my size of array is denoted with n, then at most I do n comparison, which is denoted with order of n. Third one would be the average case. That means if I either the number of comparison done is not minimum nor it is maximum, then we call it as the average case efficiency of the algorithm. Hope this is clear. This is about the time and the space complexity of the algorithm. In the next video, we'll see how to find the time complexity of an algorithm on various codes. We'll take some sample codes and we'll analyze what exactly is the time complexity of those sample codes. Thank you.